Everybody, EarlTheLogbook.com, back for more Voyages of Shelf Discovery. We're back in the room. I want to give a shout out to my buddy Icy Robots, who's also one of my patrons. He was talking about the lighting setup. I think he was talking about this gadget here, which is, it's not that big, and I think originally it was made to hold like Gundam models. But you stick three AAAs in this, turn it on, and it does, you know, it does this light show by itself. And, you know, that's like one of the best $10 I ever spent on Amazon. Now, to completely remove any glamour from this, you know, how is it sitting at the perfect height for the camera to catch it? It's sitting on top of a roll of toilet paper that I keep at my desk because I'm too cheap to get Kleenex. So there you go. You know the rules of the grab bag. I've got a box full of goodies, which I am rotating now, so I don't even know what I'm reaching in to get. And I'm just going to reach in, and we're going to open some stuff and talk about it. So our first victim is, it's Black Widow from the Marvel Retro line. This is a rarity. It's a Marvel retro figure with a weapon, with an accessory. That's it's kind of neat. So let's open up. This is actually from one of the more recent waves, if I'm not mistaken. And so it's kind of interesting that that we've got one that has an accessory, because a lot of these don't. Of course, you know, they're superheroes. Their strength or their ability to fly, or, you know, some other mental ability, you know, that's their accessory right there. And so they don't necessarily need one, and I get that. And, you know, I also get, you know, lower manufacturing costs if we don't have to make an accessory. But let's see. So she has the crossbow here. And again, the neat thing about the Marvel retro figures is, although the selection of characters is somewhat influenced by the MCU, you know, by what's going on with various Disney Plus series or the movies, the character likenesses are from the comics, you know, which also dictates the card artwork, the gorgeous card artwork. I don't think I have spent nearly enough time talking about what's on the back of the cards. Each of them has, you know, kind of a factoid card that goes with them, which repeats the artwork from the front of the card. So, you know, it's kind of like the old days with your G.I. Joes. You know, you've got your character stats card that you clip from the card, or, you know, it's a perfectly good justification to keep the whole card, which that's always my default settings. Just keep the whole card. So, I've got somebody in a box. I have, okay. This is this is one of last year's Hallmark ornaments. It's the fourth Doctor from Doctor Who. And I can tell you right now, I remember my friend Vic Sage gifted me with this, and so I thank him for that. I don't believe, Tom Baker's kind of like one of these superheroes I'm talking about. He doesn't need lights, he doesn't need sounds. I'm sure any of us would pay a couple of bucks extra if you pushed a button on this puppy and, you know, the voice of Tom Baker emerged from a speaker somewhere. But, wow, he's pretty good size. Pretty good size. I was expecting something a bit smaller, but he's kind of in scale, more or less, with Black Widow here. That's great. And look at the detailing on that. That is marvelous. I wasn't, okay, and this is a little thing that keeps his, was protecting his arms from crushing, I suppose. And as always with Hallmark, you know, their packaging is just basically tissue paper. But that's fantastic. What's really funny is that when I was, this would have been in the early 90s, it's been like 90, 91 or so, there was a 3¾-inch action figure of Tom Baker made by a Welsh company called Daypole, who was doing kind of Star Wars scale Doctor Who action figures at the time. They started out with Daleks, predictably, but they also did the Seventh Doctor and Ace, and, you know, they eventually did Tom Baker, they did John Pertwee, they did Roger Delgado as the Master, they did Santarins, and a couple of different Silurians and Davros, a Cyberman, an Ice Warrior, and they had quite a little range going. The quality of the likenesses and the paint jobs wasn't, I'll put it this way, it wasn't up to the standard of, you know, your Marvel retro figure here. But at the time, this was before you had character options doing the 5½-inch Doctor Who figures. This was the only game in town. And those of us who were Doctor Who fans and toy collectors, boy, were we happy to have them. You have no idea. And so, this just kind of makes me think of that Daypole figure a bit. Not because the Daypole figure was anywhere near this good, but it was about this tall and had maybe a quarter of the detail, and yet I was so happy to have it at the time. So, all right, so we have Black Widow, we have the Doctor. Let's see who else is in our super team-up. We have, we have Thor. And of course, you know, again, this is Thor from the comics. He does have the hammer. Okay, so we have another Marvel hero with an accessory. And again, this is from one of the more recent waves. I think this is from the wave that came out in spring of 2022. I try really hard not to just savage the cards on these Marvel figures when I open these, because of the marvelous, you know, kind of Silver Age artwork of the characters. Oh, and we have another one with the cape, kind of like the Vision. Like, this is a huge cape. Check that out, man. That is a big cape. All right. First things first. My hammer. Put that back there to await its owner. Who, okay. He's going to come out of the package a little bit easier than the Vision did. Thankfully. Thank goodness for that. But the Vision, I had to push him out from behind with the cape. But Thor, you can actually, bring out from the front. Hand the man his hammer. And, Kind of a floppy hammer. But you know there are things you can do about that. Anyway, let's move our non-Marvel character. I'm kind of surprised at how well Tom Baker stands there. Considering that it's an ornament that's meant to hang. I mean, I have a couple of Star Trek characters from the same Hallmark ornament line that do not stand as well. You figure, you know, if it's going to hang, there is no obligation to balance the feet so that they stand. So there we have Thor and Black Widow and the Doctor, who looks like, you know, he's going to stand behind Thor and do bunny ears. Heroes All. My Tom Baker's really tall. Okay, maybe he's slightly out of scale with these guys, but still, not enough for me to dock any points off of anybody. This is a nice selection. I love the Marvel Retro Legends. Yes, I back here, who you can barely see. I love the Marvel Retro Legends. Just pointing that out. And we will see who else we open in the next edition of Voyages of Shelf Discovery. Thank you for watching.